Good morning and welcome back to Coffee Break. So it's almost April, which means spring break, unless spring break already happened. I'm out of school. I'm not 100% sure when spring break is.
At least around here, it's happening for everyone next week.
Okay.
So.
All right. Well, I say we go with that then.
Yeah.
We'll give a nod to the local kids.
I feel like spring break is sort of like preview, sneak peek to summer, right? It's just like, here, quick, have like a week. And then to like,
it's that first glimmer of sunshine and freedom, and you can like almost taste it. It's like, okay, but we still have like 2 more months of school.
Right.
So, yeah.
And also, obviously, like perfect break from textbooks.
Yeah.
So,
that's nice.
What are your favorite, do you have like specific favorite books or genres that you like to read over spring break?
Oh, I usually save like a big book for spring break. Like spring break and winter break, when you've got that kind of week or two off, I like to save the big books for that I've been meaning to read and like just haven't had time to really dive into it because now you do. So yeah, so that's what I'm reading this spring break slash we don't really get a spring break, but I'm going to pretend like we do. Echo by, oh dear. I've never really had to say her name out loud before.
Muñoz. That's my
Ryan.
Guess.
She has another name.
Pam Ryan.
Oh, man. So, yeah, she wrote Echo, and this was a Newbery honor last year, and everyone kept raving about this book. And I've read a couple of her novels before. I've read Esperanza Rising and The Dreamer, which I love both of those books. I think she's fantastic. So I'm really, really excited. I got this arc in the mail, and I already set it aside in my to-read pile. I'm like, I can't wait to dive into this one. But as you can see,
it's very thick.
It's sizable. It really is. But I'm excited. It's like this kind of magical realism slash historical time periods. And yeah.
Cool.
Yeah. So I'm just, and it features harmonicas, which like, who doesn't love a good harmonica story?
You get a harmonica feature.
Right.
Nice.
Yeah. So I'm excited to dive into this one. It's going to be fun.
Nice.
Mm-hmm. What about you? What do you like to read for spring break?
Well, for the years that I was part of the privileged few to like go to Florida or somewhere warm for spring break, so there are beach reads, but there's also like beach magazines, right? If you're just like totally want to get away from the textbooks.
Yeah, yeah.
And I feel like kind of a good pairing with a beach magazine is Animal Beauty.
Oh, yeah.
Because it's sort of like the antidote.
It's all about magazines, really.
Right, yeah. Right. And it's so I feel like it'd be really fun to like, you know, read. What are the magazines that are popular with teens these days?
Seventeen. That was a magazine
around,
when I was a teen.
Right?
Okay. Yes. Okay. Cool.
Because like I didn't
I
read
know
Cosmo.
What the kids read
like,
these days.
I don't think I was allowed to read Cosmo. So
a lot of people in my high school did though.
Okay.
And I was like kind of scandalized when I found out exactly what Cosmo was.
Yeah. So maybe you read like Cosmo or Seventeen, and like, you know, it's fun. There's good stuff in there, and then you like. Read Animal Beauty because it's hilarious and then also kind of tempers the okay, you don't need to have all of these things that it says you should have.
Yeah, it's like the perfect satire to all of those fashion and beauty magazines
right.
that are like, you know, 10 tips for Kim Kardashian hair and all of that stuff.
Right, and, right.
Well, to go along with my like big giant middle grade novel, I thought I would go with a picture book, you know, something lighter and like that's really funny. And so I picked Samira and the Skeletons, and this is one of my favorite books that we have coming out this year. It actually just came out earlier this month, and it's just hilarious. It's about this girl who finds out that, you know, we all have skeletons underneath, and she's just, like, so grossed out by it. She's
like, that's freaky.
That thing is in my body. Ah. And, like, there's this great moment where she just kind of, like breaks the fourth wall there and is like, oh my god. And she starts picturing everyone as a skeleton and she just wants to get rid of hers. She doesn't want anything to do with it. And so her mom's like, okay, sit on the kitchen table and we'll carve out your skeleton, you know? Good parenting.
Jellyfish don't have skeletons. You probably don't need one either.
Yeah, they get along just fine. Exactly. Like grade A parenting right there. But yeah, it's a really funny book and it beautifully illustrates that kind of moment when it's like the glass shatters in your head and you can never unlearn what you've just heard.
Yes, totally true.
Yeah, so I really love this book, and I think that's like a fun thing to kind of read on spring break and just like revisit something that makes you laugh.
So my other favorite thing to do on spring break, sometimes I just want to reread something. Like, sometimes escapism is best when you're just like, I know that this is going to be enjoyable and it'll get me out, and it's just, yeah.
Right. And sometimes you forget like exactly what happens, and you know you like that book but you can't quite remember why,
right,
and you want to revisit it.
Right.
I get that.
So in that case, I would read Ella Enchanted. Way back in our very first episode, I mentioned that this is one of my favorite books growing up. Still super great.
And I just reread this one earlier this year, actually.
Yeah, and it's been a while since I've reread it, and I'm, like, seriously considering reading it, even though I'm currently reading four other books.
It's fine. Too many books.
Totally fine.
What's too many books?
Right. But I also just, like, you can't go wrong with medieval setting and, like, sassy heroine.
Yeah, that's it. She's so sassy.
Yeah.
I love Ella. Like, she is just a really spunky, fun heroine that you mm-hmm. just absolutely identify with.
Yeah.
She's just great.
So to all of you still in school, I would like to say, ha, I'm not in school anymore, but also this is like your week. Because this is when I am jealous.
Yeah. Yeah. They get a whole week off and we just get to stare at the sunshine out our windows.
Right.
And, yeah.
I mean, I guess we could take a week off, but, you know, comes out of vacation time.
I was going to say, but then that means no Christmas. Oh, man. So, yeah, make the most of this week that you have, you know, enjoy it however you choose. And if you're reading some good books, let us know what you're reading in the comments or on Twitter.
Definitely. We are at Coffee Break, EBYR. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next week.
Springs breaks.
No,
I was going to do like calls to Sack,
right,
where it's like Springs Break.
Right.
But that's not
and
right.
And like sisters-in-law?
Yeah.